Hello students, welcome to physics class of plus 1. We are doing chapter uniformly accelerated motion and today we are going to study about accelerated motion. And the topic which we are going to study about is acceleration and retardation. So let's start the topic acceleration. Acceleration is the rate of change of velocity with respect to time. Therefore, acceleration is equal to final velocity minus initial velocity divided by time. Or we can write it as A is equal to Vf minus Vi divided by t, where Vf is the final velocity and Vi is the initial velocity. Or we can write it as A is equal to delta V by t, where delta V means change in velocity. So this is the formula for acceleration, which is rate of change of velocity with respect to time. SI unit of acceleration is meter per second square. Its dimensional formula is 0 in m, 1 in l and minus 2 in time. And acceleration is a vector quantity, so it depends upon magnitude as well as on direction. Next is retardation. Negative acceleration is called retardation or deceleration. So we have already discussed that acceleration is a vector quantity which depends upon direction. So here in these two pictures we can see that this car is speeding up, means its velocity increases, therefore its acceleration is also increasing. It is in positive direction, so it is accelerated. On the other hand, the second car is slowing down. It means that its velocity decreases, therefore acceleration becomes negative, that is in opposite direction. So negative acceleration is called retardation. Deceleration or retardation is equal to minus Vf minus V0 divided by t, where Vf is the final velocity and V0 is the initial velocity and t is the time. Since it is negative acceleration, therefore SI unit of acceleration and retardation is same, which is meter per second square, and its dimensional formula is also same as it is for acceleration, that is 0 in mass, 1 in length and minus 2 in time. So we conclude that acceleration is change in velocity. This change can be due to change in speed, change in direction, or it might be due to change in speed as well as in direction. So any kind of change in the velocity means it is accelerated motion. On the other hand, if the velocity is constant, it is not changing, like here it is 1 meter per second square. If there is no change in velocity, means acceleration is also zero. So we call it no acceleration or zero acceleration. Next is uniform acceleration. The acceleration of a particle is said to be uniform if equal changes of velocity take place in equal interval of time. Here you can see that velocity is changing for every second with 1 meter per second. It means its acceleration is 1 meter per second square. So this is called uniform acceleration, where velocity changes equally in equal interval of time. Next is non-uniform acceleration. The acceleration of a particle is said to be non-uniform if its velocity changes unequal amounts in equal interval of time. Like here in this example, the car covers first 1 meter in 2 seconds and next 2 seconds it covers 10 meter. It means that its velocity changes by unequal amount in equal interval of time. Next is average acceleration. Students, the average acceleration is the ratio of total change in velocity to the total time taken. So formula for average acceleration is delta V divided by delta T, where A is acceleration, delta V is change in velocity and delta T is time. One more term related to acceleration is instantaneous acceleration. As the word suggests, the acceleration of a particle at any given time is called instantaneous acceleration. The instantaneous acceleration is the limit of average acceleration as the time interval approaches to zero. So when time interval is very small, that it approaches to zero, then delta v by delta t can be written in the form of differentiation of velocity. And since v is equal to dx by dt, therefore acceleration will become d by dt of dx by dt, which means acceleration is equal to d2x by dt square. Let's see vertical motion under gravity, that is free fall. A body which falls under the action of Earth's gravitational force of attraction is called a freely falling body. So, the force of gravity produces a constant acceleration which acts vertically downward, denoted by g. Here you can see that a ball is first thrown vertically upward and then it comes down. Every time its velocity is different. Its velocity might be changes, but see, it always moves with constant acceleration, that is 10 meter per second square. So let's see general equation of motion and equation of motion for freely falling body. So we have done three equations of motion. We will see that if we talk about equations of motion for freely falling bodies, how it gets changed. The very first equation we have done is v is equal to u plus at, where v is final velocity, u is initial velocity, a is acceleration and t is time. But when a body is falling freely under the effect of gravitational pull of Earth, then a changes to g, means acceleration become acceleration due to gravity. Rest all equation will be same, that is v is equal to u plus gt. Second equation we have done, s is equal to ut plus half at square. As I told earlier that a changes to g, but here we are having s, which is displacement. So when a body is falling freely from a certain height, then its height, means h, become its displacement. Therefore here s is now going to be changed into h, means in place of displacement we will calculate height, and in place of acceleration we are having acceleration due to gravity. So we get the equation h is equal to ut plus half gt square. And the last equation is v square is equal to u square plus 2as, which changes to v square is equal to u square plus 2gh. So these are the equation of motion for freely falling bodies. So let's discuss some questions. Question number 1, define acceleration, uniform acceleration and instantaneous acceleration. Question number 2, can an object accelerate without speeding up or slowing down? Question number 3, write equations of motion for freely falling body. Question number 4, draw acceleration time graph for uniform acceleration. And last question is, the distance x covered by a body is directly proportional to the square of time. It is moving with uniform velocity or uniform acceleration. That's the end of the topic. Thank you.